Citizen Television.
Greetings and welcome to another episode of The Planetary Persuader. I'm your host, Cosmic Kev, and this week's episode is for the April 20th through the 27th, 2012. Okay, so, bing, bang, boom, what do we got going on here today? That is the big question. All right, so, we have a moon going into Taurus this evening at 9:02 p.m. We also are coming down from moon opposite Saturn today. So that's kind of a big deal. And we have the sun is now out of Aries. Yes, indeed. And some would say, hallelujah. And some are like, oh, come on now. It was such a good time. And we also have Venus, of course, is still in Gemini. Mercury, of course, is in Aries. Come on, Mercury. And we've got Mars in Virgo, Jupiter in Taurus, Uranus over there in Aries, Saturn in Libra, Neptune in Pisces, and of course Pluto in Capricorn, North Node in Sagittarius. Let us begin. So, we got a new moon, folks. That's the big news this weekend. And new moon in Taurus, it happens at 12:18 a.m. So for you Friday night viewers, it's tonight. That's the new moon. When you wake up Saturday morning, whenever after 18 minutes after midnight, Pacific Daylight Time, you are going to feel new. And new in a very good way. So it's a celebration, you know, a new celebration of life. Taurus is that symbol of mid-spring. We look at Taurus as a bull. Now, the bull's key phrase is, I have. It's symbolic also, I think, of the ages between 7 and 14, when we develop our social skills and finally enter into puberty as we get out of those years. So we develop our values, really, at this time. And for people that are teachers and whatnot, this is really like the most fun age for your children. This is when you can have intelligent conversations and things aren't overdriven by what's out there yet. So, yes, are all Tauruses like only mature to 14 years old? Well, in some areas, you know, this is the downfall of Taurus. I've never met for sure many Tauruses that ever like admitted they did anything wrong. You know, it's like everything was always right for some reason. I just can't get over that. And you probably know one. And if you do, you can write me at P.O. Box 5030 Chico, California 95927. It's like, Cosmic Kev, I've got a story for you. All right. Well, I don't know. George Carlin seems so much self-abasing. I'd have to admit that. He was a famous Taurus, so we've got to I take that back. Don Rickles, another famous Taurus comedian. I don't know. He seemed like he was mad at everybody, you know. But the best thing you can do for yourself right now is just avoid spending too much. You know, I think the fascination with luxury items really comes into play when Venus moves into your second house. And since it's hanging there, it's like, what is really valuable to you? The question is, you know, what are you doing with your values? How are you building upon them? How are you working with them? And that's going to carry you through the next part of the week. I also want to encourage people, though, if you're planting a garden, the Cancer Moon in a waxing position is about as good as it gets. So that starts late Wednesday night, Thursday and Friday. So, you know, Thursday and Friday this coming week, not today, not this Friday, but as we go into next week, that's, you know, get out there and plant your seeds, get your transplants out. All systems go, people. At least in our, you know, region over here. Okay, so next thing that we're going to talk about here is your horoscope as we go through the week. So stay tuned.